Hey guys, welcome to part 2 of my Skyrim video. I mean, what did I just say? Skyrim? Skyward Sword video. That is a Sheikah Stone. Huh. Hey friend, walk yourself on over here and say hello. Maybe I don't wanna. How do you do? I'm what you call a Sheikah Stone. Glad to meet you. I'm gonna stone a few words, so I'll get right to it. You're gonna find yourself in puzzling circumstances as you make your way through this world. If you find yourself stuck and you have no idea how to move forward, come to me. I've got nothing for you right now, but down the road, when you're feeling stuck, the things I'll show you may just get you back on the right track. Good luck out there, friend. Okay. Anyway, remember to subscribe and go into the description and check out the Discord if you want updates for from all my videos. Anyway, let's go save my little Lopwing. So we can start the race. Losing frames. Okay, look, I'm gonna... Okay. Keep heading further down in this cave. Ooh, jelly. Cool. Green rupee. I love how I collected multiple blue rupees before I even collected a single green one. Red rupees? That's cool. A lot of money. Okay, let's head on out. Link. Hey Link, I was hoping I'd find you here. I heard you'd gone searching for your bird around the waterfall, so I thought I'd fly around and help you look. How's the search going? Any sign of the Lopwing? Oh no. Well, let's not lose hope yet. There's a place up ahead that Grierson and his gang always hang around. Are always hanging around. Maybe we'll find something there. Huh? Who's that? Who's calling for me? Oh, sorry Link, I got distracted for a moment. Let's go. Look, there he is. No doubt about it. That's your Lopwing, Link. Okay, we set him free. You should hurry, Link. Now that your laughing is free, you should fly to the ceremony. Before you go, I have to ask you something. I heard this voice a few moments ago. Did you hear it too? It's been happening a lot lately. It's been feeling almost like someone is calling out to me. Have you ever wondered what's beneath the clouds? Some say it's an empty, barren place, or even that there's nothing at all below, but I just have this feeling that they're wrong. Some of my father's old texts talk about the place called the surface. The old tales describe a whole world under there, far more vast than Skyloft. The thing is, no one's ever been down there to see it, and our loftlings won't fly through the cloud barrier. But I can't help imagining the wild things that might be waiting below, something I want to see for myself. Oh, sorry, Link, we don't have time to talk. Let's get going. Look, Grid's waiting for you. Just leap off the edge and press down. Don't worry about falling, your bridge will catch you this time. Yeah. I think that's running your breath to the basics just to make sure he's not hurt. You can change the direction of your wind by of your bird by tilting the Wiimote to left or right. If you want to speed up, swing the Wiimote up to gain some altitude, then point the Wiimote down to drop into a fast dive. So again, tilt the Wiimote up and then point the Wiimote down to speed up. Those are the basics of getting a bird up to top speed. So how's he handling? Do you think he's flying alright? Now the guiding your process, you can press 2 at any time to go over the basic controls again. You can also press A to charge, which is an attack that also gives you a burst of speed. Push B to slow down. Try these meetings and see how they feel. Well, that's a huge relief. I don't know about you, Link, but you're laughing. Looks like he's feeling fine great. My father and the others are probably worried about your bird, so let's go give them the good news. You want to see your progress? Of course I want to save. Press save, even though it's the second episode. Your laughing really is amazing, especially considering everything the poor guy has been through this morning. I'm going to fly back and tell Father what happened. Well, well, if it isn't Link. Word around the plaza is that you found that dumb bird of yours. Well, that's just great, because you and your dumb bird can't tell the time. All the pre-race warm-ups me and the guys did were for nothing. Now I'm all stiff. We've been waiting forever for the race start, and they delay it for you? I don't get it. The big flake gets special treatment? You're almost a man, yet you still can't seem to go anywhere without Zelda. Bet you can't even decide what to have for lunch on your own, huh? I don't think we haven't noticed the smug looks. Ooh, Zelda and I are best friends. We go everywhere together. Ugh. You think you're pretty suave, don't you? Well, don't you? Grease has been going on forever about how he's going to be the one to be with Zelda. He's really got his pompadour in a ruffle about there. Dear her. I hate to break it to you, but today's the day I bust up this adorable little fantasy you're living in. Zelda's playing the role of the goddess of space heroine. I'm the one to claim the sailcloth. When I heard she made it herself, man, no way I was going to let that scrawny clown snatch that prize from me. Oh, yes, that sailcloth off of my mind. Duh-huh-huh. Oh, man, I bet she was thinking about me when she was snitching it. Yep, I can see it now. First, I win the big race, and then Zelda and I finish the ceremony together on the statue. Just the two of us. We got a special moment alone. Nobody's stopping me and Zelda from having our moment. Oh, it's so real, I can see it. Oh, yeah. Groose, behind you. Right behind you. What, can't you two see me in the middle of? Go. Critics, I know what you just meant by our special moment alone. Nothing big, really. Yeah, I was just trying to really hear how bad I was beyond that red bird of his. Boy, am I looking forward to a fair race. Anyway, later is a look for me during the race. I'll be the one pulling off all the dangerous moves. Hi, Grease, wait up. Did you hear that guy, fair race? Yeah, the chances of that happening are just about less than zero. Either way, don't let those fools get you down, Link. Just get out there and find the best you can. I know you've got these guys beat, and deep down, I think you do too. Yeah. That's the spirit, Link. Trust me, you can win this. The wing ceremony will now begin. Participating students, please assemble. Looks like it's race time. Good luck, Link. Your attention, please. At last, we are ready to begin the wing ceremony. I was beginning to worry that we'd have to proceed without Link, but luckily that is no longer a concern. I'm glad you can all make it. Before we start, I'll explain the rules for today's competition. I have attached a small statuette to this bird, who I will then release to the skies. On my signal, press A to dash and dive off the ledge. Once you are in the air, mount your left wing. Remember to call your bird promptly down when you dive off the ledge. Whoever catches the bird and claims the statuette, they will be your champion. Those are the rules. Simple enough, should think, but do you need to hear them again? Nope. Excellent. As you all know, today's champion will graduate to the next class, bringing him one step closer to knighthood. You will also receive a gift from the young woman, chosen to play the role of the goddess in this year's ritual. Today is a special day for many reasons, but it is also the 25th anniversary of our fine institution. To celebrate the occasion, today's champion shall also receive his gift high atop the statue of the goddess. I hear the woman performing the role of goddess this year has crafted the gift herself. And as you all well know, the role of the goddess this year will be performed by the lovely Zelda. Let's see your finest flying out there. Show me just how hard you've been practicing. Also, I want to see good, clean flying. Anyone caught interfering with other riders will answer to me. That goes double for you, Grease. Alright, gentlemen, line up. At my command, the competition will begin. Go. Oh, dang. Out. Hey, don't you know this is my day to get old, Glory? Yeah, you heard him. Let's see how you fly with an egg on your face. You got the bird statue, right? Here's your victory today. Wait till Zelda sees this. Link. Don't worry, I'm fine. Great flying, Link. Congratulations. Now we better get on with the ceremony. Link gave me that red statuette you gave in the race. I must offer it to the goddess. Great goddess, guiding light and protector of our people, grant us your blessing and mercy as I act in your stead during this ceremony. Valiant youth who grasped victory at the celebration of the bird folk, in accordance with the old ways, I now bestow the blessings of the goddess upon you. The blessings of the goddess drift down from the heavens with loft sail, which I now pass on to you. You cut the sailcloth. You cannot jump from any height without fear of a painful landing. It smells nice too. Link, quit goofing. This is supposed to be a sacred ritual, remember? You know, they say that the goddess gave the sailcloth to her chosen hero long ago. Of course, the one you're holding isn't the same one. I've been working hard to finish this sailcloth in time to give it to today's champion. I'm really glad I got to give it to you, Link. Make sure you take good care of it, okay? Thanks for making it up here to do this with me today, like you promised, Link. Oh, you should finish up this ritual. You do know what happens at the end, right? Really? Huh, I thought you would have figured it out by now. You have to jump off the statue. Look down, see the big round design on the courtyard below? To finish the ceremony, you drop down right into the center of it. Leap off the ledge here. Right before you hit the ground, press B to open up the sailcloth. Just how brave are you? If you were really fearless, you'd wait until the last second to use your fearless. You ready to jump? That was perfect. You're amazing, Link. You know, Link, seeing as how you won today, with the weather being so nice, I think maybe you'd like to, you know, go flying around the clouds together. Link, hey Link. Today was amazing. Watching you win the race and performing the ritual together, I'll always remember this. It really was wonderful. You know, Link? There's something I've been meaning to talk to you about. What is that? What's going on? Ah, Link. Link. I am waiting for you. Time has come for you to awaken. You are vital to a mission of great importance. Link. Oh, you're awake. You're left and carrying you back. You were limp and unconscious. I feared the worst. Fortunately, you don't appear to have any serious injuries. For that, you can be grateful. But Link, where's Zelda? She was with you, was she not? What's happened to my daughter? Black tornado, you say? That was no ordinary storm. You must not push yourself. You're still recovering. Tell me, when you saw Zelda today, did anything about her seem off? I see. She was talking about the surface then. You've been having dreams about a great mission. How interesting. I'm sorry, I was lost in thought there for a moment. It's all strange. Very strange, but I doubt there's much of a connection between these things. I'm concerned for Zelda, but so long as she's with her Wafflung, I'm sure she'll be fine. Either way, daybreak has yet to arrive. It would be very difficult to spot one girl and a bird in the dark of night. It would also be very dangerous. Rest now, Link. Zelda's going to be fine. She's out there alive, I know it. This is where the real game begins. Rupee like jumped that gap. isn't that. I'm sorry. Keys, to be exact. Only chosen by my creator, I have been waiting for you. You will play a role in a great destiny. According to your social customs, I should provide you with my personal designation. Fee is the name I was given. I was created for a single purpose, long before the corrupted memory of your people. I must aid you in fulfilling the great destiny that is your burden to carry. Come, Link, you must take up this sword, as the one chosen by my creator is your destiny. The strange dreams troubling your sleep, my sudden appearance, uncertainty surrounding the fate of one you hold dear. In the circumstances, it is only logical that you would exhibit some apprehension. To minimize your uncertainty, allow me to share some information. My projections indicate that this information has a high probability of altering your current emotional state. The one you seek, Honorable Zelda, is still alive. And this spirit maiden, the one you call Zelda, is another chosen one fated to be part of the same great mission. Therefore, you should you wish to meet with your friend, I highly recommend you take up this sword before you set out to search for her. Does that information invigorate you? Are you ready to accept this sword? It seems that further persuasive measures will not be required. In the name of my creator, draw the sword and raise it skyward. You got the God of Sword. This mysterious sword is bathed in divine light. Recognition complete. Master. Link. My master. Link. I've had my suspicions, but until now I wasn't sure. Here we are again, the Chamber of the Sword, the very place where the youth of the legend would one day appear. It is said that this place was left to our people by the goddess herself. The very knowledge of this dream's existence is a secret passed down to the select few each generation, along with a handful of words. When the light of the goddess's sword shines bright, the great apocalypse awakes from its long slumber. Do not fear, for it is when a youth guided by my hand shall reveal himself in this place most secure. I think that's sacred. It started days ago. The sword that I've kept secret all these years, it began to give a faint otherworldly light. At first I was sure I was seeing things here, alone with the sword. There was simply no other explanation. I never dreamed the prophecy of legend would come to pass in my lifeline. The words I have sworn to keep secret are coming true before my very eyes. The youth will be guided by one born from the blade, one who is also youthful in likeness, yet wise with knowledge immeasurable. Yes, the oral tradition, one of the least reliable mentions of information retention and transmission. It appears that critical sections of the passage have been lost over the generations. The youth who draws forth the guiding sword shall be known as the goddess's chosen hero, and it is he who possesses an unbreakable spirit. He shall be burdened with the task of abolishing the shadow of apocalypse in the land. Such is his destiny. With the spirit of the blade at his side, he shall soar over the clouds and plummet below, and united with the spirit maiden, shall bring forth a piercing light that resurrects the land. Someone of Father's old texts talk about a place called the surface. The old tales describe a whole world below, far more vast than Skyloft. Master, you must embark on a great journey beneath the clouds to the vast realm of the surface. It is only through this journey that you can fulfill the mission set before you by my creator, the goddess. It is also the only method available for you to reunite with the spirit maiden, Honorable Zelda. This is no easy task, Link. The world below is a forsaken place, and to reach it, you must pierce the cloud barrier below. In living memory, no one has ever done this. This tablet will illuminate a path through the clouds to the land below. Take it and place it within the altar behind me. Get the emerald tablet. The weathered surface of this heavy stone tablet seems very old. Feels very old. Master, the first thing you must do is hit the crest sitting in this room with the Skyward Strike. These blasts are formed of pure energy that charges within your blade when you lift it skyward. Once you have charged your blade, face the crest and swing your sword to send out a powerful Skyward Strike. Oh, I'm not close enough. Last Link, it is done. Until now, a cloud barrier created by the goddess has separated the world you know from the one below. To have it placed in the altar, it's open a small barrier. You can use it to travel below the clouds to the one below. I have recognized you as my master, and so it is my duty to follow you wherever you may go. I reserve everything short and will accompany you in travels. Press down to summon me whenever you require my assistance. Link, listen a moment. The nature of the Great Apocalypse mentioned in the old text is a complete mystery to me. But whatever it turns out to be, it seems that both you and Zelda have big roles to play in the destiny of this land. Just think that if what this feast says is true, Zelda is alive. Alive and no doubt coming to terms with whatever it is the goddess has in store for her. Should you heed the call of destiny, I don't know what dangers you may have to face, Link, especially down there. But if you decided to brave the unknown, please find my daughter and bring her back to me. What I've seen here today defies explanation, but is only the start of your journey. Please see it through and prove the lessons true. Okay. You do your people proud, Link. Dawn is drawing near. It has been a long night for both of us, hasn't it? You have a great journey before you, Link, and those clothes, they don't look up to the task. The uniform you were to receive for winning the race should be ready for by now. A sturdy uniform like that will prove much more suitable for a long journey. I didn't read the rest of it, whatever.
Let's save. But I do believe I'm going to be ending this episode here. So, thanks for watching, and I will see you next time.
Remember to check out the Discord, and it's in the description, and subscribe. I'll see you guys next time. I'm gonna finish this though first. I'm gonna skip through the dialogue. Seen our hero all dressed up? Alright. Take care on your journey and be sure to stop by some of the shops of the bar here in town to equip yourself properly for the job. Whatever. I'll return to my quarters and see if I can glean more useful information from the ancient texts. You're always welcome to stop by if you have questions. You and Zelda shall be in my prayers. May the goddess watch over and guide you both. See you guys next time.